Hello everyone, welcome to Math Cyberspace. This is Dibendu Gonai and here I am with you with the biography of one of the greatest mathematician of the history of mathematics. He is usually considered to be a French mathematician, but the Italian encyclopedia refers to him as an Italian mathematician. Joseph Louis Lagrange was an Italian-born French mathematician who excelled in all fields of analysis and number theory and analytical and celestial mechanics. Lagrange was born on 25th January in 1736 to a well-to-do family. His father was a treasurer of the Office of Public Works and Fortifications in Turin, but he lost his fortune as a result of bad investments. Young Joseph was intended to be a lawyer and attended the University of Turin with that goal. It was not until the age of 17 that he became interested in mathematics. His interest was created by a paper he came across by the astronomer Edmond Halley. And entirely on his own, Lagrange dove into mathematics. In just a year, his course of self-study was so successful that he was appointed to be an assistant professor of mathematics at the Royal Military Academy. There, he taught courses in calculus and mechanics until it became clear that he was a poor educator, though a highly talented theorist. At the age of 19, Lagrange wrote to Leonhard Euler, the world's greatest mathematician, describing his new ideas for calculus. Euler was so impressed that he recommended Lagrange for membership in the Berlin Academy at the extraordinarily young age of 20. Euler and Lagrange continued their correspondence, and as a result, the two collaborated on developing the calculus of variations. Lagrange is one of the founders of the calculus of variations. Starting in 1754, he worked on the problem of the tautochron, discovering a method of maximizing and minimizing functionals in a way similar to finding extrema of functions. Lagrange wrote several letters to Leonhard Euler between 1754 and 1756, describing his results. He outlined his delta algorithm, leading to the Euler-Lagrange equations of variational calculus and considerably simplifying Euler's earlier analysis. Lagrange also applied his ideas to problems of classical mechanics. In 1758, with the aid of his pupils, Lagrange established a society, which was subsequently incorporated as the Turin Academy of Sciences. And most of his early writings are to be found in the five volumes of its Transactions, usually known as the Miscellanea Taurensia. Already by 1756, Euler, seeing Lagrange's mathematical talent, tried to persuade Lagrange to come to Berlin, but he shyly refused the offer. In 1765, D'Alembert interceded on Lagrange's behalf with Frederick of Prussia, and by later asked him to leave Turin for a considerably more prestigious position in Berlin. He again turned down the offer, responding that, "It seems to me that Berlin would not be at all suitable for me, while Mr. Euler is there." In 1766, after Euler left Berlin for St. Petersburg, Frederick himself wrote to Lagrange expressing the wish of the greatest king of Europe to have the greatest mathematician in Europe resident at his court. Lagrange was finally persuaded. Lagrange always maintained his daily schedule. Every night he set himself for a definite task for the next day, and on completing any branch of a subject, he wrote a short analysis to see what points in the demonstrations or the subject matter were capable of improvement. He carefully planned his papers before writing them, usually without a single eraser or corrections. In 1767, he married his cousin Victoria Conti. During his years in Berlin, Lagrange's health was rather poor, and that of his wife Victoria was even worse. She died in 1783 after years of illness, and Lagrange was very depressed. In 1786, following Frederick's death, Lagrange received similar invitations from states including Spain and Naples. And he accepted the offer to move to Paris. Lagrange was extremely active scientifically during the 20 years of spent in Berlin. Not only did he produce his mechanic analytic, but he contributed between 1 and 200 papers to the Academy of Turin, the Berlin Academy, and the French Academy. Some of these are treatises, and all without exceptions are of a high order of excellence. Between 1772 and 1788, Lagrange reformulated classical or Newtonian mechanics to simplify formulas and ease calculations. These mechanics are called Lagrangian mechanics. His productivity in those years was prodigious, and he published papers on the three-body problem, which concerns the evolution of three particles mutually attracted according to Sir Isaac Newton's law of gravity. Differential equations, prime number theory, probability, mechanics, and the stability of the solar system. Euler proposed Lagrange for election to the Berlin Academy, and he was elected on 2nd September 1756. He was elected a Fellow of the Royal Society of Edinburgh in 1790, a Fellow of the Royal Society and a foreign member of the Royal Swedish Academy of Sciences in 1806. In 1808, Napoleon made Lagrange a Grand Officer of the Legion of Honor and a Count of the Empire. Lagrange was awarded the 1764 Prize of the French Academy of Sciences. In 1766, the Academy proposed a problem of the motion of the satellites of Jupiter, and the prize again was awarded to Lagrange. He also shared or won the prizes of 1772, 1774, and 1778. In 1810, Lagrange commenced a thorough revision of the mechanic analytic, but he was able to complete only about two-thirds of it before his death in Paris in 1813 on 10th April. This was all about the short biography of Lagrange. If you want to know about the biographies of more mathematicians or scientists, then stay with us. I will be here next Sunday with another great person. Thank you.